Okay, very good afternoon to all of you. We'll continue our discussion. Let us first have a look at the syllabus content. Just for confirmation, is the screen visible and am I audible to you all? Anybody can say yes. Is the screen visible and am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Great. So, we are learning computer organization subject. And we are in unit 3 of computer organization. If you remember, in the last session, we had taken cache memory. And we had identified various keywords, and using those keywords we tried to connect with the topic cache memory, like what is a hit ratio, what is a hit, what is a miss, what is a locality of reference, what is the meaning of mapping, what are the three types of mapping, be it associative or direct or set associative mapping. That was what we had taken as far as cache memory was concerned. Now, we are into the last topic from unit 3, that is virtual memory. So, this topic also we'll try to connect with and try to understand with the help of the keywords visible in our textbook, Maurice Monroe textbook, and with the help of few diagrams which are there in that Maurice Monroe's textbook. That is a prescribed syllabus book which we are using for learning our unit 3 of computer organization. So this is the topic virtual memory. Now, the opposite word to virtual memory is what? Physical memory. The opposite word to virtual memory is physical memory. Physical memory means what? Actual memory. Then virtual memory means what? It is not actual memory, but it gives the impression to the user and the programmer. That it is actual memory. It is not actual memory. It is a virtual memory. What is the advantage of that, or why we should use virtual memory? As mentioned here, the virtual memory concept is used to create an illusion to the programmer that his memory is bigger and his memory is as big as the secondary memory. So that is what is the meaning of virtual memory. Okay. Now, for that, we also need to understand how our program execution or task execution is done by the CPU. That we are pretty clear about anyway. So a program, when you write a program, you will be storing that program. That program will be available in the auxiliary memory whenever you have stored it. But when you want to execute that program, you know that you have to make use of the CPU, because CPU will be executing the program. When CPU wants to execute the program, CPU needs the data and the program, if not complete, partially. So some component as much as its capacity and so on. So what the CPU will be doing, CPU will be bringing that program and the data in the main memory. The CPU will be bringing the program and the data in the main memory. Now, this is the usual concept. Now, when we are using virtual memory, what will happen is the main memory address space, as well as the auxiliary memory address space will be treated as one, okay? So that will create an illusion that there is a large memory space created. Now, what the CPU will do? The CPU has to access the data, has to access the instructions. Now, for accessing the data and the instructions, CPU needs addresses. Now, whenever there is a virtual memory concept, whenever there is a virtual memory concept, what CPU has to do is CPU has to do the mapping of the virtual address to the physical address. The CPU has to do the mapping of virtual address to the physical address. Now, I have been repeatedly telling the purpose of virtual memory. What virtual memory does, it gives or it creates an illusion in the minds of the programmer or the user that they have a very large memory at their disposal. Okay, but the actual memory will be the main memory, which is a smaller memory. The actual memory will be the main memory, which is the smaller memory. Okay, now, in such a case, whenever we are using this virtual memory concept, there is a need for converting the addresses which are generated by the program into the actual main memory addresses, This is done dynamically, as mentioned here. I'm just reading it verbatim from the book, this line. So this is done dynamically when the program execution is going on by the CPU. Okay. For this translation, for this conversion, what translation, what conversion? Okay. So translating a program generated address into the main memory address. Because program generated address will be part of the virtual memory. But we want that to be mapped with the actual main memory address. So this mapping is done dynamically when the execution is going on. When CPU is doing the execution, this mapping is done dynamically. For doing this mapping, a data structure called as mapping table is required. Hopefully you are all with me, because this is a very simple concept. But if you are listening, then only the remaining content which is being discussed will make sense to you. So let us see this again, virtual memory. Just remember virtual memory. Virtual memory, opposite of physical memory. Physical memory, actual memory. So virtual memory, not actual memory, but it creates an illusion of actual memory. What is the benefit? The benefit is the programmer gets the feeling that there is a huge memory at his end. He need not worry about the memory aspects. So there is a transparency maintained with the programmer or the user, because programmer or the user doesn't know anything what's going on behind. Only he feels that there is a big memory available. Wherever this virtual memory concept is used, he gets the feeling that lot of memory is available with me, big memory is available with me. How big? As big as the hard disk, as big as the secondary memory, as big as the auxiliary memory. Suppose your hard disk is 1 terabyte. It means a virtual memory of 1 terabyte is available plus the main memory, So that is what is the simple meaning of virtual memory. Now, what is the headache? The headache is the CPU has to do this translation of addresses. Which addresses? The addresses are generated by the program. So these program generated addresses, they have to be mapped with the actual main memory address. So this mapping is the headache. So for mapping, there is a data structure used called as the mapping table. If you are with me and in tune with me, then the next keywords will make sense to you. The two keywords which we are going to refer are, one is address space and the second one is memory space. I am referring two words here. The previously, which word I have used? The first word I had used was virtual memory. In virtual memory, any specific word I use? Mapping table, a data structure called as mapping table. Now the two keywords I am using is address space and memory space. Okay. Address space, you relate with virtual memory. The moment the word address space comes, you relate that with virtual memory. So you should say that the address space are virtual memory addresses. The address space are virtual memory addresses. It means what? What is memory space then? Memory space means the actual physical addresses. Memory space means the actual physical addresses. Just this, keep this imbibed in your mind and make a note of it, that the two words refer to two different memories. Address space refers to virtual memory. Memory space refers to physical memory. Memory space refers to physical memory. Okay. So this you have to remember. Now, let us also remember that address space means virtual memory. Virtual memory means what? Virtual memory means as big as the auxiliary memory, as big as the hard disk. So memory space means physical memory, main memory. So always the hard disk memory is bigger than the main memory, RAM memory. The hard disk memory is bigger than the RAM memory. It means the auxiliary memory is bigger than the main memory. It means the address space is bigger than the memory space. So I just put this down in the chat window, this line, that address space is bigger than the memory space. So this you have to keep in mind, address space is bigger than the memory space. Let us take an example here. Let us take an example here. Main memory. What is the size of the main memory? 32,000 words. 32K words, 32,000 words. 1,000 here is, in computer terminology, it is 1024. Simple things are there if you are listening. If you are listening. Main memory size. What is the main memory size? 32K. 1K means 1024. For referring this 32K, you need 15-bit. Okay, address lines. You need 15-bit address lines. Okay. So this is a main memory. Means this is a physical memory. Means this is not a virtual memory. So we are speaking about a memory which is not a virtual memory, which is a physical memory, which is a main memory. Okay. So the size, this is for example only. The size is, let us say, 32K words. The size is, let us say, 32K words. For referring these 32K words, you need 15 bits of address lines. You need 15 bits of address lines. Okay. Because 32K indicates 2 to the power of 15. 32K indicates 2 to the power of 15. Similarly, let us say the auxiliary memory. The auxiliary memory capacity is 2 to the power of 20. The auxiliary memory capacity is 2 to the power of 20. 2 to the power of 20 means how much? 1024K. Compare this 1024K with 32K. Okay. Compare this 1024K with 32K. Which one is bigger? 1024K is bigger. 32K is smaller. 1024K is auxiliary memory. 32K is main memory. Okay. 1024K is a candidate for virtual memory. 1024K is a candidate for virtual memory. It means which is bigger? Virtual memory is bigger. 1024K is bigger. So 1024K virtual memory is bigger than this 32K. Is bigger than this 32K. How much bigger? This 32K, okay, this 32K means 32,1024. So it is actually capable of creating 32 main memories. This virtual memory is actually capable of creating 32 main memories. Now, we are speaking about virtual memory. The address space of the virtual memory, let us denote as N. The address space of virtual memory, let us denote as N. And the memory space of the physical memory, let us denote as M. Just in case you have forgotten, these are the two keywords. Address space, memory space. Address space means virtual memory. Memory space means physical memory. Memory space means physical memory. So when I refer address space, I'm calling it as N. When I'm referring memory space, I'm calling it as M. In this example, what is the value of N? The value of N is 1024. The value of N is 1024. What is the value of M? The value of M is 32K. M means what? Memory space. N means what? Address space. Hopefully you are with me. Okay, you're all with me. Now, Our computer system is a multi-programming environment. What is the meaning of multi-programming environment? Multiple programs are executing at the same time. Means CPU has got the capability of executing multiple programs at the same time. At the same time means it may be using some mechanism like round robin or some mechanism wherein it will be giving service to all the programs available. It will be giving service to all the programs available. In this context, let us look at this diagram. Let us look at this diagram. You spend few seconds, maybe 20 to 30 seconds, in just observing this diagram. Okay, if you have absorbed this diagram, let us go very slow. In this diagram, this is main memory. Main memory means physical memory. This is auxiliary memory. Auxiliary memory means secondary memory. This is main memory. Main memory means RAM. This is auxiliary memory. Auxiliary memory means hard disk. Suppose Navyashri or Vinay or Balram, they have written a program called as a Python program. So that Python program, they have saved it. When they have saved it, that program and all the data related to that is available in the auxiliary memory. Is available in the auxiliary memory. So now this program has to be executed. This program has to be executed means it has to be brought in the main memory. It has to be brought in the main memory. So now, with the help of the auxiliary memory, what can be created? Virtual memory can be created. With the help of the auxiliary memory, virtual memory can be created. How virtual memory is referred as? It is referred as address space. What is the address space? The address space are memory addresses generated by the program. Addresses generated by the program. This address space is denoted by what? N. This address space is denoted by what? N. Similarly, memory space. Memory space is the physical address, physical locations in the main memory. So this is denoted with the help of M. This is denoted with the help of M. The previous example, wherein we mentioned 32K and we mentioned 1024K, see here the same example is here. 32K is main memory. 1024K is auxiliary memory. 1024K is virtual memory, like this. 1024K is virtual memory, like this. So in this diagram, what is visible? The program and some partial data is brought into the main memory. Program and some partial data is brought into the main memory. This is what is shown in this diagram. This is what is shown in this diagram. Okay. Now, please remember that the as far as our addressing was concerned, the physical memory requires only 15 address lines, while the virtual memory requires 20 address lines. The physical memory requires 15 address lines, and the virtual memory requires 20 address lines, and the virtual memory requires 20 address lines. So what do we do now? What do we do now is, we had already said that there is a mapping to be performed. There is a mapping to be performed. And this mapping is to be performed with the help of what? This, for performing this mapping, we have to use a special data structure. For performing this mapping, we have to use a special data structure. That data structure is called as mapping table. But what is the meaning of mapping here? The meaning of mapping is translation, conversion. What we are translating, what we are converting? We are converting the addresses which are generated by the program which the CPU is executing into actual memory locations in the main memory. Into actual memory locations in the main memory. So this is called as mapping. Here, in the previous discussion of cache memory, that mapping was different. This mapping is different. This mapping is different. As per the context, you try to remember the meaning of them. Now, so you may be requiring a data structure like this for that mapping. Looking at this diagram, just absorb this diagram also. Just absorb this diagram also. So, as we said, there is a main memory. Address lines are 15. There is a virtual memory. Address lines are 20. But there is a special data structure called as mapping table. Okay. So this mapping table will be performing this mapping of the virtual addresses with the physical addresses, of the virtual addresses with the physical address. You also require the memory table buffer register or main memory buffer registers. So what may happen usually is sometimes your whatever the extra data structure you are requiring, it may be separately kept in the form of an associative memory, or it may be kept in the main memory, or it may be kept in the virtual, not in the virtual memory usually, but in the main memory or as an associative memory. That way the implementation is done. Hopefully you're all with me till now. Okay. So if you are not with me till now, you can just remember that the topic being discussed is virtual memory. So here there is a data structure used called as mapping table. This will be translating the program generated addresses into main memory addresses. Two keywords being used are address space and memory space. Address space for virtual memory, memory space for physical memory. These N for the address space, M for the memory space, M is the main memory, N is the virtual memory. Virtual memory is bigger than the main memory. That is what we are seeing here. This data structure memory mapping table is used to do that mapping. Now, there is a concept called as pages also. So I'll put this keyword again in the chat window. Pages. Okay. So here you have to remember two things. Pages are logical. While the other word is blocks. So blocks are physical. Pages are logical. I put both the words in the chat window. The first word is pages and the second word is block. So pages are logical while the blocks are physical. It means what? Blocks refer to a main memory and pages refer to virtual memory or logical memory. Why we are discussing all that? Because the task in hand is mapping. What is mapping? Translation. Translation of virtual addresses into physical addresses. How it is done? So basically, your physical memory or the main memory is divided into blocks. The block size may be 64 or 4096 words. Okay. Similarly, your logical memory or the virtual memory is divided into pages. So the contention is the page size and the block size are same. Okay. So let us say 1K is the page size. Similar will be the size of the block size. Okay. So your logical memory means what? Your program. Okay. So your program also is logically assumed to be split into pages. Okay. So now let us look at the diagram directly and try to connect with the diagram. Focus on the diagram for a few seconds, please. Okay, so now let us slowly look at this. This is address space, means virtual memory, means logical memory. Address space, virtual memory, logical memory, denoted by N. How much it is? 8K. How much it is? 8K. So basically, you require 2 to the power 13. Okay, so 13 address lines are required. 13 address lines are required. Now, this is our program, let us say. This is our program space, let us say. So your programs are divided into pages. Your programs are divided into pages. So how many pages you are seeing? You are seeing 8 pages here. Page number 0, page number 1, page number 2, till page number 7. So totally 8 pages you are seeing. Totally 8 pages are seeing. It means what will be the page size? The page size will be 1K each because the address space size is 8K. So 1K plus 1K plus 1K 8 times will be 8K. So 8 pages each of size 1K. So that becomes the 8K. This is what this diagram is showing us. Similarly, let us look at the right side part. What the right side part says, there is something called as the memory space. There is something called as the memory space. Okay. So memory space is physical space, physical address, physical location. It is denoted by M. It is denoted by M. So you can see here, 4K is the size of the memory. 4K is the size of the memory. So this is the physical memory, actual memory. This is the physical memory, actual memory. So this physical memory, actual memory, you are dividing into blocks. This physical memory, actual memory, you are dividing into blocks. What is the block size again? The block size is 1K only. So how many 1Ks? 4 1Ks. So how many blocks? 4 blocks. What is the size of each block? 1K. So this all these exercise, why we are telling? Because there is a mapping need to be done. So with the pages and the blocks, mapping of the pages and the blocks has to be done. Mapping of pages and the blocks has to be done. So for that, you can refer this diagram also. You can refer this diagram also. Just absorb this diagram for a few seconds. Just look at this diagram for a few seconds. Okay, so just remember the concept which we are using. The concept which we are trying to understand is the concept called as mapping. The concept called as mapping. This is what? Address mapping using pages. Address mapping using pages. Which address mapping using pages? Logical address with physical address, virtual address with physical address, because we have created a virtual memory. We have created a virtual memory. Hence, there should be a mapping to be performed. Hence, you need a mapping table. Hence, you need your virtual memory to be divided into pages, and you need your physical memory to be divided into blocks. See here, the pages and the blocks. The pages and the blocks. Now, this diagram will explain us how that mapping will be facilitated. Let us remember the number of bits here. How many number of address lines we are seeing here? 13 address lines we are seeing here. 13 address lines we are seeing here. Now, out of these 13, the how you call it? Is it MSB? This 101. So this MSB 101. So the 3 bits out of those 13 bits, these 3 bits will decide the page number. How many pages are there? 8 pages are there. First page is page number 0. Last page is page number 7. So 8 pages are there. So page number 0, page number 1, page number lastly, page number 7. So this will be telling us the page numbers. This will be telling us the page number. Okay. Now, after that, you see something called as a presence bit. You see something called as a presence bit. Presence bit means if it is 1, the particular block is available in the main memory. If it is 0, it is not available in the main memory. If it is 0, it is not available. So whenever memory fetch has to be done, whenever data and program are to be fetched, whenever data and program are to be fetched, the presence bit will decide, determine whether it is there or not, whether it is present or not, whether it is present or not. Now, the page number will be telling the page which page it is, or inside the page again at which exact location we have to go, that will be determined by the remaining 10 bits. That will be determined by the remaining 10 bits, which will be specifying the line number, which will be specifying the line number. Okay, so with the help of this main memory register, with the help of this main memory register, address register, we are combining these blocks, or not combining actually, we are mapping these blocks with the help of this data structure called as page number and line number. With the help of the data structure called as page number and line number. Let us try to look at this discussion somewhere mentioned. This is figure number 12.19. So let us look at here. How many words are there? 8 words are there. Okay. First word, second word, third word, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. 8 words are there. Now, later on, what it is saying? Okay. So, for each page, there will be 8 words. Then, what the table is showing, pages 1, 2, 5, 6 are available in the main memory. Pages 1, 2, 5, 6 are available in the main memory. Okay. So are available means presence bits is determined. Present, this is page number 1. Okay. 1, 2, 5, 6. Let us look at, okay. Page number 1, page number 2, page number 5, and page number 6. So these are available. These are available. And they are available at which place? They are available at block number 3, block number 0, block number 1, and block number 2. Block number 3, block number 0, and block number 1, and block number 2. That also is mentioned. In which block they are present? These pages are present in which block? So that is there. What is a presence bit? Okay. So presence bit means the page has been transferred from auxiliary memory to main memory. If it is 0, it is not there. If it is 1, it is there. If it is 0, it is not there. If it is 1, if it is 0, it is not there. If it is 1, it is there. Okay. Out of the 13 bits, the 3 high order bits will be used for what? They'll be used for specifying the page number. These are the 3 high order bits which will be used for specifying the page number. So that content will be read in the memory page table. Okay, that content will be read in the memory page table. Buffer register. It is somewhere here, MBR. So this basically is the concept. Now you can make an add-on, you can make use of associative memory for the same mapping. Okay, so when you use the associative memory, you know this argument register, key register, and associative memory concept using the matching register will be used. Now here again, your virtual address has physical page numbers and the line numbers, page numbers and the line numbers. And while the associative memory has the blocks, page number and the block number. This is the only significant difference, because when you are moving from this way of organization to associative memory organization, actually your efficient memory management is being done efficient, because here in this case, a lot of wastage of memory locations is there, which will not happen here, which will not happen here. Now comes one of the most important word which you should remember, that is the page replacement. I'll put that in the chat window again. Page replacement. Now, which are the various page replacement algorithms? I'll tell you. One algorithm for page replacement is FIFO, first in, first out. And the other algorithm is least recently used. Okay. But basically, what is this page replacement? what is this page replacement. For that, you need to understand these three lines. Okay. Which page in memory is to be removed for a new page? But basically, you need to remember page also. You need to remember page also. What is a page? These are the pages. Your logical address or your program address space, you are dividing them into equal size pages. So these pages are to be brought to the main memory. These pages are to be brought to the main memory. Okay. And not all the pages can be brought at the same time, right? It means only few pages can be there. It means some pages are to be removed, some pages have to be brought, like that. So which page to remove, which page to bring, so all that. So all that concept is to be done. Okay. So let us say there is a page in the main memory. That page has to be removed. It cannot be there always because some other page should take its place or take its space. Okay. Whenever a new page is brought to the main memory, when it has to be done. Okay. So whenever a new page is brought into the main memory, where it has to be placed. So all that discussion comes under or facilitated with the help of page replacement. Now let us see a scenario where a program is being executed. When a program is being executed, the CPU will access the main memory for that program contents. If they are not there, it means the page is not there. If the page is not there, means a page fault has occurred. Whenever a page fault is occurred, the program is suspended and CPU will be taking some other program for execution. And it will wait till that particular page is loaded. So loading of the page is the job of the IO. So that job is given to the IO processor. Okay. So remember one more word, page fault. What is the meaning of page fault? The meaning of page fault is that CPU is executing a program. Okay. But for executing that, it has accessed main memory. Where it has accessed main memory, it did not find that. So, when it does not find a particular page, that is called as a page fault. So now when a page fault occurs, page replacement algorithms will be used to bring the pages. The two algorithms which we mentioned is one is first in, first out. The other one is least recently used. Okay, least recently used. Okay, what is the meaning of least recently used? We need to have a counter kind of thing which will determine how much you this particular page was utilized for execution. So the one which is having lower utility will be removed. The second one is first in, first out. Whichever has come first has to go out first. So this basically in entirety is the concept of virtual memory. So what we can say is from unit 3, today we have covered this introduction to virtual memory concept. Hope you listened carefully.